الله من الشيطان الرجيم. إنما التوبة على الله للذين يعملون السوء بجهالة ثم يتوبون من قريب فأولئك يتوب الله عليهم وكان الله عليما حكيما. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن ولا الذين يموتون وهم كفار أولئك أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. صدق الله العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. So yesterday we read about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's direction, which said فَإِن تَابَ وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَعْرِضُ عَنْهُمَا. When somebody makes tawbah, when somebody seeks repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gives up their evil doing, then the people, what should the people do? They should stop blaming them for it and leave them. Now, these two ayah talk about the relationship of a person who makes repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deal with it? إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Allah, the relenting taken by Allah upon Himself. So the meaning of this is that in a way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken it upon Himself to accept the tawbah of those people. Nothing becomes compulsory for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have no right over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made wajib upon Himself out of His mercy. Out of His mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it incumbent upon Himself in a way. Although in the true sense of the matter, in true sense of the word, nothing becomes incumbent upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ. Those people who do evil in ignorance. ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. Then they repent shortly thereafter. So two things, those people who commit su or evil bi jahala. What is jahala? Ignorance. It has been translated here as ignorance. So one thing is that a person commits a sin and they don't even know that it is a sin. That would be one form of jahala, which is a very obvious form. That somebody who does something and they don't know that it is a sin, that is definitely a form of jahala. Then another thing is that somebody knows that it is a sin, but they do it unintentionally. For example, we put something somewhere which becomes a cause of discomfort for some other people and we didn't even know. So there's other examples. Somebody commits a sin, they know it's a sin, but they did it unintentionally. That will be a form of jahala. But mercy upon mercy is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has Himself explained it from the tafsir of other ayat. It is very clear that jahala and the understanding of the sahaba and the way the Prophet ﷺ has explained this in his ahadith is that jahala also includes when somebody commits a sin knowingly and intentionally. Even if somebody does a sin knowingly and intentionally, it will still come under jahala. It will still come as they are doing that sin ignorantly, out of ignorance. Why? Because jahala is, the Sahaba Kiram have explained, Hazrat Mufassirin have explained, that every sin that is committed is a jahala. Every sin that is committed is a jahala. And how so? It is jahala because the preference has been given to the pleasure of a temporary world over a permanent and perpetual life. Every sin and disobedience is done out of jahala, because it is extreme jahala to leave the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the most beloved to us and who loves us more than anyone else, who loves us more than us ourselves, and we give preference to our own desire. So that is always a jahala. So all sins committed unintentionally, unknowingly, or intentionally and knowingly, they all come under jahala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking out of His mercy, upon taking it upon Himself, that those sins committed, if then tawbah is asked, if repentance is asked from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the tawbah. ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. then these people repent or make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shortly thereafter. So one meaning would be, and this is how a mu'min should be, that whenever they commit a sin or disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right after it, very soon, very quickly, they should come back and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. But again, the mercy after mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained this qareeb. And that qareeb is, that qareeb ends, this duration of qareeb ends when a person starts to see the things of the other world, right at the time of their death. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that tawbah is accepted until a person gets the gharghara of death, the situation in which their soul is being pulled out. So these two things, every sin committed, if repentance is sought for it before death takes over someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken it upon himself that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept their repentance. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is announcing this clearly in his book, then it remains for no one to doubt that somebody is asking tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it will not be accepted. Even the person who is seeking the tawbah themselves should not doubt in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we have taken it upon ourselves out of our mercy that we will accept the tawbah. فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. So Allah relents towards them. Allah grants their repentance. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. And Allah is all-knowing and all-wise. عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. عَلِيمًا, عَلِيم basically means all-knowing. So Allah is all-knowing who is making a repentance seriously and with regret in their heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Hakim. Even if people do not seek repentance, fulfilling the four the conditions of tawbah, even then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his wisdom, keeps a veil upon them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not disgrace them publicly. كَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. So the ulama have mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in fact it comes from collecting different hadiths on this subject, that tawbah is granted when three conditions are fulfilled. The first is, and the first and the foremost, the most important one is to have a regret in your heart that whatever I did, it was wrong, I should not have done it. There has to be regret, at least spoken from the tongue. Even if the heart does not want to say it, even if the mind does not agree with it, it has to be at least uttered with your tongue. The second condition is that it should be given up. Tawbah becomes valid when the sin that we are doing, we leave that sin, we give up that sin. At least in the time, in the moment that we are making tawbah, we should give up that sin. And the third is talafi. Talafi is compensation. So if we have committed a shortcoming in the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as salah, siyam, zakah, tawbah will be accepted when we fulfill them. If you've missed salah, we complete those salah. If you have missed fasting, we keep those fasting, those kind of things. And if we are making repentance upon something where we have a committed shortcoming in fulfilling the rights of the people, we have to fulfill those rights and do a compensation as prescribed by the Sharia, and then our tawbah will become complete. This next ayah explains the duration of qareeb. What is the duration in which tawbah is accepted? وَلَيْسَتِ التَّوْبَةُ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ حَتَّى إِذَا حَضَرَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ قَالَ إِنِّي تُبْتُ الْآنَ وَلَلَّذِينَ يَمُوتُونَ وَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ أُولَٰئِكَ أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. This relenting is not for those who do evil deeds until when the time of death approaches one of them. He says, now I repent. Nor for those who die while they are still disbelievers. For them we have prepared a painful punishment. So two or three things we mentioned. Number one is that يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ would mean يَعْمَلُونَ is something that he is doing it and they keep on doing it continuously. So Hazrat Mufassirin have explained that يَعْمَلُونَ would mean that somebody commits a sin, does not make tawbah, then does it again. Then does not make tawbah, then does it again. So perpetual sinning would be when somebody is not even making tawbah between their sins. If somebody commits a sin, then makes tawbah, then that is wiped off. Now they are, if they again commit that sin, it will not be called that they are committing it again. It will be basically when the previous one was wiped off by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then they will not be counted as people who are constantly doing sin, or somebody who has israr, perpetually doing that sin. These will be the people who will be called perpetual sinners, would be the ones who keep on committing sin after sin without tawbah in between. Hatta idha hadara ahadahumul maut, that they keep on committing sins and they see death. Maut, huzur maut basically means that they start to see. It is defined as when the person starts to see the angels, for example, the malikul maut, those kind of things. Then things of the other world, for example, the stairway and those kind of things, then tawbah is not accepted, as explained and clarified by the story of Fir'aun as well, that when he saw death and he started seeing the things of the other world, he wanted to bring faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not accept it. وَلَلَّذِينَ يَمُوتُونَ وَهُمْ كُفَّارِ, these people do not die except that they are disbelievers. وَهُمْ كُفَّارِ أُولَٰئِكَ عَتَدْنَا لَهُمْ وَلَلَّذِينَ يَمُوتُونَ وَهُمْ كُفَّارِ. And tawbah is not also for those people who die on a state of kufr. Ulaika a'tadna lahum adaban alima, these are the people for which we have already prepared a painful punishment. So the biggest tawbah is from kufr towards iman. And people, if people die in a state of kufr, then their repentance is not accepted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant a perfect tawbah, grant us a tawbatun nasuha, a perfect tawbah. Zadul Fasreen have explained in under this ayah that not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken it upon himself to forgive, but mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is such that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in other places of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only forgives, not only wipes away the sin, but also wipes away from the memories and the book of deeds, from the memories of angels and the book of deeds. The only place where that sin remains is in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never wiped, but all other witnesses of that sin are wiped away. And not only is it wiped away, but the act of performing tawbah is a maker of beloved of someone, is a reason for somebody becoming a beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned in several places of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes them a beloved. So only by uttering the words of tawbah and fulfilling the conditions of tawbah, one not only wipes away their sins but also becomes a beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم إنا نسألك توبة نصوحة اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقرب إلى حبك صلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين